in the back of a vehicle, late at night. I sit blindfolded, on my way to an unknown location. My phone's off, and since I'm not in my work car, there's no tracker. The driver and a second passenger sit silently up front. We're going completely off the grid. Once we've arrived, I'm not allowed to film the property or any person. Focusing exclusively on the reason I'm here. This is a place used to grow marijuana, a grow house. The process is meticulous, ensuring optimum growing conditions for maximum yield. Powerful lights are attached to the ceiling, beaming down an artificial light for a very specific period. Then, complete darkness, 12 hours on, 12 hours off. There are multiple varietals of the plant, each for a different purpose. Some are grown from seed, others from clippings from adult plants. These are called clones. When the plants have reached a certain size, they're moved to another room where the conditions are optimized for budding. After harvesting, they'll be picked and packaged for distribution. But marijuana of this grade isn't going just anywhere. This crop is destined for the shelves of dispensaries across South Africa. Meanwhile, in another part of the country, this time during the day, things are a little different. Johan and Mirishin are a couple who have been openly selling medical marijuana for the past 3 years.
We started it out like just between friends, just a safe haven to go and buy your cannabis from. Like I said earlier, you don't want to go to Sunnyside and go through that old rigmarole. So it was a safe haven for everyone to come and buy their weed.
And then a lot of friends, I've got a lot of friends, and then we realized that we can help a lot more people than we thought we could. And then this happened.
Openly advocating the use of this plant for its healing properties, they stock and sell their products to clientele who are seeking an alternative to pharmaceutical drugs.
We shouldn't really call it high anymore, no. We should, when one of our clients explained, he said he doesn't want to, it's not that he wants to be high all the time, he just doesn't want to feel so low. And I mean, that turns everything around. Then suddenly it's an antidepressant as compared to just a happy drug.
But this is no simple goods exchange. A client must come in for a consultation, sometimes lasting longer than 2 hours, and a specific strain, product, and dosage is prescribed.
Yeah, well, there's three main families. Now, indica is your more medicinal one, more from India, Asia, those places. That is the one with significantly more CBD.
And most medicines are made from indicas because people need to sleep. It also induces your appetite, which is important for some people. You can't heal if you don't eat.
The sativa, if you look at Swazi and Malawi, very high, or it can have very high THC levels, but the ratio between THC and the CBD is just a lot bigger. So there's less CBD, you can have a much more what they call a cerebral high, a head high. So you're going to be more energetic. Each strain will have a different ratio of these 113 cannabinoids, so it's going to have a different medicinal effect on you.
In some cases, clients are turned away, Johan or Mirishin determining if a client is using too much of the plant or using it inappropriately.
It's also a place of responsible adult use, and that sits very close to our hearts. You know, if there's someone that comes in here and he's 19 years old and he has got and he's smoking maybe a little bit too much, in our opinion, because it is an opinion. Just see the amount of times when Mirishin have stopped people from buying certain strains because it's too strong for them. Because once they leave here, we have to take responsibility for what we give them.
And some clients swear by it.
I was eventually on 13 different pills a day. It completely changes who you are, what you are. And I was still using Concerta to wake up, and I was using a drug called Stonox to go to sleep. When I started recreationally, I was on 13 pills. I was on antidepressants, I was on mood stabilizers. It was around then that this drug kind of came into my life, you know, with friends. And I was like, okay, this is kind of doing everything these drugs have promised to do, you know?
There's no downside to it. Your antidepressants, there is a downside. There is always a downside. I see in a pharmaceutical. I as far as possible, try to stay away from them. With medical marijuana, if it's done responsibly, it can be really life-changing. It can be something that if you embrace it, you're really going to enjoy it.
The products range from simple smoking to oils and cookies, each with a different application and each combating a different ailment.
Just a normal vape battery, pop it off, that little piece of shatter you just put on there, close it up again.
It hasn't always been smooth sailing for the couple, who acknowledge that what they are doing may have been illegal, but that people they see always leave better than they arrive. Strong advocates for industry regulation, the couple say that dispensaries like theirs and their clientele will benefit under legalization and proper supervision.
It's happened to us twice now, where we've been arrested and not actually seen a judge, which is, you think it's a good thing, but it's not as good, because we would prefer to get a stay of prosecution and go through the correct procedures. Because at the moment it feels like you're getting arrested and you're losing a lot of money every single time, and someone's taking all that stock and someone's taking all that money.
While the couple has been prescribing these products for the past 3 years, it is in March that the High Court ruled that adults could grow and use marijuana in their own homes. It's now up to the Constitutional Court to ratify this ruling. While this isn't yet a green light for the dispensary, they say it's a step in a promising new direction.
I think it's important for everybody to know that there is a whole cannabis community in this country that's been alive for hundreds of years, and there are growers that's been growing for, and there are oil makers, and there are people who know cannabis better than anybody in America that are here, that are local, that are able to start this for the people.